Ever since I was young, I saw how my parents work hard to make both ends meet. We were cramped up in a small 20 square meter room we were renting when we moved from Tacloban to Davao. As the eldest child, I was in charge of doing the laundry, ironing and cooking for my younger siblings when my parents were away from work. My mom would ride the bus from Davao to Tacloban to sell pak chorizos, and my dad would travel from another city for his job. I was a typical eldest child with dreams of being able to help my family. Growing up, I started to have peers who influenced me to drink, smoke, and get into group fights because it made me feel cool. But despite these peer influences, I never flunked my class. In November 2002, I passed the board exam in civil engineering. In my first job as a structural engineer, we had a supplier who invited us to Manila for a product presentation. The next day, the client invited us to go to CCF St. Francis. It was my first time to attend a Christian church. During the service, I felt like the middle-aged Chinese pastor was directly talking to me. His message penetrated into my heart, and at the end of the service, he asked us to stand and pray. And unknowingly, tears were rolling from my eyes. Upon returning home to Davao, I started attending CCF there and also volunteered my skills as an engineer. However, my relationship with the Lord did not grow deeper. At the age of 25, I was appointed by a huge company as the project manager of a multi-billion project and to oversee all the construction. This is when I learned to compromise. Contractors will take me out to bars to bribe me to award projects to them and fast-track their billings. Money and power enticed me. I easily earned my first million at a very young age. Knowing that I have more than enough savings and experience, I resigned from work to pursue my dream of putting up my own design and build company. In that same year, I married my girlfriend and became a father a year after. On our third year in the construction industry, my partner and I became involved with government projects. We practiced every kind of deceit, cutting corners, and bribing. We would not pay the right taxes. We would falsify the quantity of materials needed for a project. And then we would easily bribe the inspector for his signature without having to inspect the site. We were able to get contracts through connections without proper bidding procedures and accreditations. Bribing and compromising became normal because everybody was doing it. Because of these transactions, our business started to earn more and more. But despite the success I was experiencing, I never had a peace of mind. I could hardly sleep at night because of the burden I carried as CEO. I rarely had the time for my family because all I thought about was our business and money. In October 2015, my wife and I were invited by one of our clients to attend the CCF couples retreat. I had no intention of attending because I thought I could not afford the time. But the couple who invited us were very intentional, and eventually we agreed to attend. Hearing the testimony and messages of the pastors was an eye-opener for me. After the retreat, I started to devote my time to prayer, reading and meditating on the scripture so I could understand God's direction for me. In one of my quiet time, I felt convicted after reading Proverbs 16:8. Better a little with virtue than a large income with injustice. I cried out to God for forgiveness in deep sincerity. I knew that I've been bringing dirty food in my table. And I prayed to him, Jesus, Lord, forgive me for not living your way. Come into my heart and lead me on the path you have for me. After that, I called my business partner so we could end all our illegitimate business transactions. He was doubtful, but God's grace, he did not resist. It was tough at first knowing our expenses and knowing that our income has reduced. The process was both difficult and humbling. At some point of my Christian walk, a client even said to me, "Walang Christian-Christian sa negosyo." This broke my heart, knowing that person is also a fellow Christian. This experience taught me that not all proclaiming to be Christians are genuine in their faith, and that some live a double life. After that, he provided enough cash flow to cover the company's expense. In that season, I learned what it means to obey God's word and to trust him in any circumstances. Walking with God has been such an amazing journey. I regularly commune with him. He is my first, my moment by moment, and last appointment each day of my life. I now know that God gave me gift as a builder, that my business is a platform for his glory. So I am building to my very best, clinging to his words in Colossians 3:23. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as working for the Lord rather than for men. He has provided us with a family of believers who encourage us in our walk. By his grace, I am now being used to bring others to an understanding of forgiveness and love of God. The more I seek to know Christ, the more I trust him. The more I love God, the more I am faithful to him. And because I am faithful to Christ, I am faithful to my wife, my children, my business partner, to my work, and my friends. I have not perfected my walk with the Lord. I am still a work in progress, and I hang on to God's promises to walk me through the process. I am aware that from time to time, God will put me in the furnace like a blacksmith, hammering the sword until all impurities will fall off, and all he can see is his reflection on the sword that is me. It is always my heart, my character, the Lord examines. When time comes, I will ultimately stand before the throne of grace. I hope the Lord will say to me, "Well done, my good and faithful servant." I am Mark Sid Ferras, a steward, a husband, a father, a follower of Christ who happens to be a builder. To God be the glory.